HIV symptoms in men after 6 months. Hello, this is Mark Medicals with the latest on HIV cure news, HIV treatment, and ways HIV is transmitted. In this video, I will tell you about the following. 1. What happens 7 to 14 days after HIV exposure? 2. What happens in 14 to 28 days? 3. What happens 29 days to 20 years after HIV exposure? 4. When is the best time to test for HIV after exposure? Alright, let us get started and answer the questions. What happens in 7 to 14 days after HIV exposure? From the site of infection, like from the genitals, HIV is carried to the next lymph nodes where some of the infection occurs. Infection usually takes 0 to 72 hours, beyond which HIV elimination is impossible. This is a reason we recommend taking your HIV treatment called PEP drugs within 72 hours, because once an infection has taken place, HIV may never be eliminated from your body. The first 7 to 14 days period is called acute retroviral syndrome. In this period, your body has not yet fully recognized the virus, and this gives it the chance to rapidly replicate, reaching billions of HIV copies. From research published, 40 to 90% of people will experience a body rash and other flu-like symptoms, along with other signs and symptoms like fever, sore throat, night sweats, fatigue, swollen lymph nodes, erectile dysfunction in men and others. What you should know is that 10 to 60% may not experience any symptoms. 2. What happens after 14 to 28 days? By day 14, your body will already have identified the virus, and so your immune system will start fighting hard to control HIV rapid multiplication. The mentioned early HIV symptoms will start disappearing and you will feel better. What you should remember is that even the HIV negative people experience the same symptoms, and therefore having those signs and symptoms does not mean you have HIV unless your HIV test is positive. HIV infection is only confirmed by taking an HIV test, as I have been telling you guys. Though symptoms typically show up in the first 1 to 3 weeks, it is still possible to experience them in the first 3 months. 4. What happens 29 days to 20 years after HIV exposure? The chronic stage sets in once your body has controlled HIV to the lowest replication levels. During this time, HIV goes into hiding within your CD4 cells and other parts of the body. You will stop experiencing any HIV-related symptoms for many and more years, till your CD4 cells have been destroyed to normal levels. During the chronic stage, enlarged lymph nodes may be the only notable sign of HIV infection. Your lymph nodes may enlarge to more than 1 inch in size, and if enlargement lasts for more than 3 months, we call it persistent generalized lymphadenopathy. Though HIV is hidden during this period, it continues to destroy your cells of the immune system called CD4 cells till a level you will be diagnosed with AIDS, the last stage of HIV infection. AIDS is the stage of HIV infection characterized by CD4 cells of below 200, and symptoms like oral sores or oral candidiasis, unexplained persistent fevers, severe uncontrolled diarrhea leading to rapid weight loss, and many others. With no HIV treatment, people living with HIV usually advance to AIDS stage within 5 to 15 years. So as you can see guys, most likely there will be no HIV symptoms in men after 6 months. 5. When is the best time to test for HIV after exposure? There are 3 types of HIV tests, i.e. NAT tests that detect the actual HIV DNA or RNA, 4th generation HIV tests that detect HIV antigens and antibodies, and rapid antibody-only HIV tests. HIV window period is the time after infection to when your HIV can be detected on standard tests. You will get a false negative test if you test within the window period of your chosen test. NAT tests like PCR will detect your HIV within 10 days, but maximum accuracy will be obtained from 45 days. Fourth generation tests detect HIV by 14 days, with maximum accuracy from 45 days, and your test results from the antibody-only rapid test will be conclusive from 90 days.